date is September 11th, and I'm calling the Borough of Beach Haven meeting to order at 7 o'clock. And we have the flag salute led by Mr. Cactus.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Pursuant to the New Jersey Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting has been provided by posting on the bulletin board in the entrance hall of the Beach Haven Municipal Building, mailing the same to the Beach Haven Times, the Asbury Park Press, and the Press of Atlantic City. Mr. Cactus.
Here.
Mr. Lynch.
Here.
Mr. Maskell.
Here.
Mr. White.
Here.
Mayor Davis.
Here. And we have the Borough Manager's report.
Cash receipts in the current fund account for the period August 1st through August 31st were $5,845,048.79. Cash disbursements in the current fund account for the month of August totaled $3,379,255. The cash balance in the current fund account as of this period totaled $12,247,285.19. Cash receipts in the water utility account for the period of August 1st through August 31st were $122,922.70. Cash disbursements in the water utility account for the month of August totaled $61,642.69. The cash balance in the water utility account as of August 31st was $2,567,100.47, submitted by our treasurer, Sherry Holder. Our beach badge sales report for 2017, these were the sales through September 3rd, totaled $451,455, so the unaudited totals. Compared to last year's totals at $483,180, less than last year. We did take into account 19 rainy or cloudy days this season, and they did not require badges on Wednesdays. Tonight we're having a public hearing and final adoption of the final steps to settle the coal litigation after 9 years. We're excited about that. Yes, I just wanted to read real quick my 9/11 poem by Alan Jankowski. Let the world always remember that fateful day in September, and the ones who answered duty's call should be remembered by us all, who left the comfort of their home to face perils as yet unknown, an embodiment of goodness on a day when men's hearts had gone astray. Sons and daughters like me, never questioned what they had to do, who by example were a source of hope and strength to others who could not cope. Heroes that would not turn their back, determination that would not crack, who bound together in their ranks and asked not a word of thanks. Men who bravely gave their lives, whose orphaned kids and widowed wives can proudly look back on their dad who gave this country all they had. Actions taken without regret, heroisms we shall never forget. The ones who paid the ultimate price, let's never forget their sacrifice. And never forget the ones no longer here who fought for the freedoms we all hold dear. And may their memory never wane, lest their sacrifices be in vain. That's all I have.
Thank you. Today, I have something to read from Constitution, something to read. Whereas the Constitution of the United States of America, the guardian of our liberties, embodies the principles of limited government in a republic dedicated to rule by law. And whereas September 17th, 2017 marks the 230th anniversary of the framing of the Constitution of the United States of America by the Constitutional Convention, and whereas it is fitting and proper to accord official recognition to this magnificent document and its memorable anniversary, and to the patriotic celebrations which will commemorate it, and whereas Public Law 915 guarantees the issuing of a proclamation each year by the President of the United States of America designating September 17th through the 23rd as Constitution Week. Now, therefore, I, Nancy Taggart Davis, by virtue of the authority vested in me as mayor of the borough of Beach Haven, do hereby proclaim the week of September 17th through the 23rd as Constitution Week. I ask our citizens to reaffirm the ideals of the framers of the Constitution held in 1787 by vigilantly protecting the freedoms guaranteed to us through this guardian of our liberties. In witness thereof, I have hereupon set my hand and caused the seal of the borough of Beach Haven to be affixed this 11th day of September of the year of our Lord 2017. Right, we now have approval of minutes. We have minutes from June 12, 2017 regular meeting, June 21st, 2017 agenda meeting, July 10th, 2017 regular meeting, and July 19th, 2017 agenda meeting without formal reading. Has everybody read the minutes? Is there a
motion to approve the minutes as submitted?
Second.
Favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Ordinances 2017-23C, an ordinance of the Borough of Beach Haven to implement the Borough's third round housing plan element and fair share plan consistent with the terms of a settlement agreement reached between the Borough of Beach Haven and the Fair Share Housing Center regarding compliance with the Borough's third round affordable housing obligations in accordance with, in regards to New Jersey AC 5:96 and 5:97, 221 NJ 1, the New Jersey Fair Housing Act, and relevant regulations and policies adopted by the New Jersey Council on Affordable Housing, final reading.
This is the final reading, and if anybody would like to speak to this, please come up to the microphone and state your name and address.
My name is William Barris. I'm at 100 Northwest Avenue in Beach Haven. And I think my question may have been answered. It's really important to me that any development in Beach Haven that exceeds 5 units has to comply with the code of climate. I read a section of the proposed housing share element yesterday. I think that's what it says. But if there's anything else that's going to be developed in this town, given the size of the commitment we made to COA, the settlers litigation, we need every available COA unit we can get. So I just want to make sure every available COA unit we can get. My understanding, and I just want to make sure, because this is for final adoption here, that any development, not just the overlay zone that we designated for the business district, any development in the borough of Beach Haven for more than 5 residential units will contain a COA
right
in accordance with I believe that's what it says.
That's right.
But
there are a lot of people
that are going to read fine print, and you know who I'm talking about with respect to these things. So I just want to make sure that that's what it is.
That's how I read it, and it's a separate number on that list. It doesn't say if there's a separate statement on the overlay area and a separate statement.
I hear what you're saying. I just think that that's real important for everything we're trying to accomplish here.
Thank you. Anybody else would like to come forward and speak to this ordinance? that case, I have to say, reiterate what Sherry said, this is very exciting because we have been working on this for quite a long time. And I think it's a good thing for the town and the island. So do I have a motion to
approve 23C?
Second.
Francis?
Yes.
Lynch?
Yes.
Rassell?
Yes.
Yes.
Mayor Davis?
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-24C, an ordinance of the Borough of Beach Haven, Ocean County, to amend Chapter 19 Land Use of the Municipal Code to establish an affordable housing overlay zone ordinance in the Borough of Beach Haven. Final reading.
And again, this piggybacks on the last ordinance. Would anybody like to come up and speak to this ordinance? Therefore, I will close the floor to discussion. Is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Francis?
Yes.
Yes.
Rassell?
Yes.
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 Ordinance 2017-28, bond ordinance authorizing various capital improvements and acquisitions in and for the Borough of Beach Haven in the County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, appropriating $1,213,000 therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $964,000 bonds or notes to finance part of the cost thereof. Final reading.
Again, this is final reading. Is there anybody that would like to speak to this? There are detailed lists of what this money is going for, which are available. Okay, I close the floor to comment. Is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve 2017-28.
Second.
Francis?
Yes.
Lynch?
Yes.
Rassell?
Yes.
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-29, capital ordinance of the Borough of Beach Haven in the County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, authorizing various water system improvements by and for the borough and appropriating therefore the sum of $325,000 from the Water Capital Improvement Fund for the borough. Final reading.
Again, is there anybody that would like to speak to this ordinance? I would like to make a comment myself. Our water utility, we really improved it, the infrastructure, and everybody's getting good pressure in the chain. Is there a motion to approve this ordinance?
Motion to approve 2017.
Second?
Second.
Mr. Cassis?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mr. Massimo?
Yes.
Mr. White?
Yes.
Mayor Davis?
Yes.
2017-31, bond ordinance amending and restating bond ordinance number 2016-13, finally adopted by the Borough of Beach Haven, the County of Ocean, State of New Jersey on June 13, 2016, to increase the appropriation therein by $500,000 to finance part of the additional cost thereof. Final reading.
Again, would anybody like to come up and speak to this? Therefore, I close the floor to public comment. Is there a motion?
Motion to approve 2017-30.
Second.
Mr. Cassis?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mr. Massimo?
Yes.
Mr. White?
Yes.
Mayor Davis?
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-21C, an ordinance amending an ordinance entitled Code of the Borough of Beach Haven, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, as it pertains to Chapter 48, Amusements, first reading.
This basically is going to help some of the places in town that have video games and that sort of thing. It reduces some of their costs, which are really high. Is there a motion to approve ordinance 21C?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Mr. Cassis?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mr. Massimo?
Yes.
Mr. White?
Yes.
Mayor Davis?
Yes.
2017-25C, an ordinance amending and supplementing Chapter 212-16 signs of the Borough Code of the Borough of Beach Haven, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, to regulate flashing neon animated and digital signs. First reading.
Again, this ordinance is updating the technology that's occurred over the years. We have an ordinance that does not allow digital and neon signs, but there's some discussion as to what that means. So this is sort of updating the technology. Is there a motion to approve this ordinance?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Mr.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mr. Massey.
Yes.
Mr. White.
Yes.
Mayor Dooley.
Yes. Ordinance 2017-30C, an ordinance supplementing Chapter 136 nuisances of the Borough Code of the Borough of Beach Haven, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, to include light trespass as a recognized and prohibited nuisance within the borough. First reading. Again, this piggybacks on the last ordinance. There's been problems with light pollution, and this deals with that. Is there a motion to approve this ordinance? Is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Heck.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mr. Massey.
Yes.
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-32C,
an ordinance creating Chapter 59 bicycles of the Borough Code of the Borough of Beach Haven, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey. First reading.
Again, you can all get copies of these ordinances and read them in detail, but as you know, we have a lot of confusion with bikes in town, and a lot of people have feel that it's dangerous, and this ordinance is trying to help that. It's very hard to enforce these bike ordinances because people riding bikes don't have to carry licenses. So it's hard for enforcement, but we are prohibiting riding bikes on the sidewalks, and we are prohibiting riding large four-wheeled bikes or three-wheeled bikes like Surrey's and that sort of thing on the boulevard. And that's basically what the essence of this ordinance is.
And it's putting us in compliance with the state.
Yeah. Okay, is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve 3370.
Second.
That was
32C. Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mr. Massey.
Yes.
Mr. White.
Yes.
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-33C, an ordinance amending Chapter 57, 4, C, 2, B, 3, Protection of Beaches and Dunes of the Borough Code of the Borough of Beach Haven, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey. First reading.
This makes it a little bit more specific. Are there some people that have walkovers that if you have private property on the we found that if the walkover doesn't extend a little bit onto the beach, the dune breaks away. So that's why we have this ordinance to help protect the dunes. Is there a motion to approve this ordinance?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Mr.
Heck.
Yes.
Mr.
Lynch.
Yes.
Mr.
White.
Yes.
Ordinance 2017-35C, an ordinance amending Chapter 151-1, Property Maintenance of the Borough Code of the Borough of Beach Haven, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey. First reading.
This ordinance is dear to my heart, and actually a member of the community, a resident, came up and talked about this. This is really encouraging people and allowing people to put native natural vegetation on their property, particularly in the medial utility strip. I think it's a really great thing to promote. Is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Second.
Mr. Heck.
Yes.
Mr. Lynch.
Yes.
Mr. Massey.
Yes.
Mr. White.
Yes.
Mayor Dooley.
Yes.
All matters listed under item consent agenda are considered to be routine by the municipal council and will be enacted by one motion in the form listed. Any items requiring expenditure are supported by a certification of availability of funds, and any item requiring discussion will be removed from the consent agenda and discussed separately. All consent agenda items will be reflected in full in the minutes.
Would anybody like to remove any of these items for discussion?
We did add resolution 184-2017. It's a resolution pertaining to the construction of the borough's new municipal building and the issuance of the borough's general obligation bonds to the USDA in financing a portion of the cost thereof. Resolution of the borough of Beach Haven authorizing and providing for the incurrence of indebtedness for the purpose of providing a portion of the cost of acquiring, constructing, enlarging, and or extending its municipal building facility to serve an area lawfully within its jurisdiction. Resolution 186, returning remaining escrow. 194, returning park bonds. 196, authorizing execution of a shared service agreement with the Ocean County for the Driving While Intoxicated Enforcement Program and Drug Recognition Expert Call-Out Program. $199, returning street opening bond. $200, adopting the revised spending plan for affordable housing. $201, authorizing submission of raffle applications 12 and 13. $203 is approving change order number 7 for the new municipal building. $204 is approving change order number 8 for the new municipal building. Resolution 205 is approving change order number 9. $207 is returning dumpster bonds. $208 returning piling bonds. $209 returning curb and sidewalk bonds. $210 amending the shared service agreement for construction code enforcement services, Schedule A, B, and C. $212 approving change order number 1 for emergency repairs to existing drainage in Amber and Holyoke. $214 canceling taxes. $215 approving change order number 10 for the municipal building. $216 authorizing submission of raffle applications 14 and 15. And finally, $217 awarding a contract to Shore Connection for the 2017 drainage project, Leeward, Amber, and Atlantic Avenues.
Anybody would like to discuss any of these separately? Do I have a motion to approve?
Motion to approve the resolutions as read.
Second.
Mr. Francis?
Yes.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mr. Maskell?
Yes.
Mr. White?
Yes.
Yes.
I have a bill list this evening in the amount of $3,544,997.26.
Has everybody read the bills?
Yes. Yes. No questions.
Okay. Is there a motion to approve?
Second.
Texas?
Yes.
Lynch?
Yes.
Maskell?
Yes.
Mr. White?
Yes.
Mayor Davis?
Yes. Okay. Now I'm opening the floor to public comment. If anybody would like to get up and comment. Forward, state your name and address. Yes.
John Halperin, 319 Fairview Avenue. I'm also president of the Beachhead Taxpayer Association. And I know the bicycle ordinance that was put into introduction tonight is something that was endorsed by the Taxpayer Association. And the introduction of ordinance through our efforts, we have discovered that it's a dangerous situation on bicycles on sidewalks, causing numerous accidents. And again, the board of Beachhead Taxpayer Association fully endorsed and support that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And it's nice to know that we're listening to you guys. So, thanks for working so hard and shape.
You're welcome.
Anybody else like to come forward?
This is going to be a little stupid, but I only wanted to say thanks to John Halperin for showing up tonight, because he had a sign at the Maritime Museum banner the other day that said something along the lines of helping Beach Haven keep the taxes in line. I said, well, what do you do? And I said it would be nice if he came to a meeting once in a while, and he's here. So thanks, John, for coming.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Bill.
Thanks, Bill. Thank you. Okay, so now we have nobody else. So anybody else want to come forward before I close the floor? Nobody? Okay, so I'm closing the floor to public comment. So we have final remarks by council. All right. Would you like to start?
I would. First of all, I'd like to apologize for wearing a hat. I'm holding a bandage on my head, so I can't take it off. But to reiterate what Sherry read in that beautiful poem, I feel kind of bad that Beach Haven does nothing for something on the 11th, like we started to do it a few years past. I hope that this day that has a huge impact on so many people, so many people that I knew and loved that were lost that day, doesn't ever leave our hearts and minds. It's something that's so tragic. There's over 1,100 people that still haven't even been identified. So the tragedy goes on for many, many people. You must always remember what happened that day and always fight to keep our liberties, and especially to thank the men and women in uniform that performed the duties to keep our country safe and not seeing a reoccurrence of this. So please keep in mind, everybody, that this is something that should never go away. It should be something that is indelible in our minds forever.
Thank you.
To follow in the same vein, I just would like everybody to remember those who perished, those who first responded, those who lost loved ones. God bless America.
A fine.
Okay. Vaughn?
Again, reiterate what I said earlier about 9/11. We're going to know where we were on that day. And just keep those people in our prayers. Two, business related matters. The draft of the master plan was issued. It's online. We have a meeting at the Land Use Board this Monday. Well attended, there was great feedback, and I know the Master Planning Committee is still looking for feedback on the draft of the Master Plan. I suggest that people read it and continue to provide the feedback so it's the best document. It really sets the vision for the BGM for the next 10 years. You know, the last item is, everybody sees the municipal building under construction. Right now, the target completion is about mid-November, early November. So, working hard at making sure this project gets done on time. So, that's it.
Thank you. I just have a couple of things. I'd like to reiterate the November 11th. Jim brought that up. My daughter-in-law sends me this wonderful poem every year called Falling, and it's very touching. And I didn't get it this year, so I don't. I do want to mention that there is a meeting of mayors on the next Monday at 3:00 to talk about the taxing, the cost of the school taxes relating to Southern Regional, and I will be there. That should be interesting. And I do want to thank everybody's hard work that are concerned about the taxes in Beach Haven, as well as all the other important things that we need to do. But lots of good things are happening here in town. We hope within a very short period of time we'll have a pavilion on Taylor at the very end of Taylor Avenue overlooking the bay. That's coming up. That's very exciting. And we have a great ramp on Pearl Street where people can get their boats in and out of the water. They're little boats like kayaks and paddle boats. I mentioned that as well as the volleyball. And everybody here on council is working hard to make Beach Haven as good as it can possibly be. And it's the town, the people in the town are also such a great asset to Beach Haven. And I want to thank Don specifically because he really has been a tremendous asset to this Borough Hall project. He's an engineer, but he's also done this sort of thing through his job with J&J for many years. So he's really kept on top of all the aspects of what's going on there. And it's a huge asset for us here in Beach Haven to have somebody with this expertise that's put so much time and effort into this. And I really thank him. And that's about all I have to say. Again, Constitution, we keep that in mind. It's important. We're so lucky to live in a country like this and this democracy with the Constitution we have. And that's all I have to say. So do I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.